Hi friends, in this video we will see about the access modifiers shorthand notation, how we can represent that one in the TypeScript. Now here, if you see here, you have here the name string. You have in the class one property with the name string, and when you want to initialize this name with the data, so what you are doing, so you are initializing the data using the constructor. Whenever your user creates an object of this class, so you are creating a constructor, and this name you are assigning into the property of this class variable. Okay, so that means the assigning is taking three steps. That is nothing but what you can say, you are first declaring the property, and next your argument you are passing through the constructor. In that constructor you are assigning to that property with the argument. So these three steps are going on. So you can avoid these three steps while declaring the property. For example, tomorrow you will have another variable. You will be having for the class so many properties you will be having. So now you need to pass this ID also. I can pass this ID using something like ID string. Okay. Now I can pass that this dot ID is equal to ID. Okay. So I have to do like this. Tomorrow if so many items comes like this. Okay. If so many properties are there. So each time you need to initialize here the property, and again the argument will be passing here, and here you need to place this like that. So in the TypeScript you have a shorthand notation, and here you will be having something like this one is a public public property, this is public property. You can write here something like, you can write here this one as a private, and this one is a like a public. Okay, so this one is a private and this one is a public. Now you are declaring like this, right? So we can represent using this one as a shorthand notation. We can represent, how we can represent is nothing but what we can do is, so here we can remove this value, okay, and also this value. I can remove these two things, and I can directly write the private here and also the public here. Okay, I can remove these two things. So this shorthand notation is nothing but what we can say is, it's nothing but the initialization of the property and also the assigning the property into that assigning that variable data into the property. Remember that this ID, whatever the name you are giving in the construction, this will become the property of the class. Okay, if you give here n, you cannot access this dot name here. So here this dot name got error. See, you can access using this dot n. So that means, so you need to give the property name here, and also you can directly give the access modifier also here, so that the property will be created with that access modifier. So this is the shorthand notation how we can represent. And now if you go here, you can directly use the property this dot name. This is how we can represent the shorthand notation. And also you can see here I got an error, so that means I need to pass an ID to this one. So what is that ID, how I can pass that ID? Here I can use, that one is a string, right? I can use department one, some d1. Now we are passing d1 and account ID, ID and name to the constructor, so that the properties automatically, name and ID will be created, and that value will be stored in this appropriate accordingly into the properties. Now I can use this ID and name here, print employees or something like, yeah, here describe method is there, right? So in this describe method I can directly use, so we will use that literal string format. So department with ID, I can keep it in the bracket something like this, okay, dollar of this dot ID, and I can use directly, so dollar of this dot name. I can use the template literal form like this. Now if I see the errors, nothing, no errors is there. So if I go and execute here, and if I refresh the thing, we are not using the describe, I think, down. Yeah, we are not using any describe here. So let's add here a describe. Okay, now let's see what could be the output. If I see the output here, if I refresh this one, so now here I got the ID, department with ID d1 is equal to accounting. So I am able to access both the ID and the name of the properties directly, we are using this dot ID. So in the constructor like this, we are by the creating like this private and public. So remember that we can also represent the shorthand notation. Instead of writing declaring the property top and also assigning this dot name and all those things, stop doing, you can also directly use this shorthand notation of the representation of the access modifier properties. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.